وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، my beloved brothers and sisters, what has been going on recently on social media and news outlets regarding our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? We're living in a time of trials and tribulations. It's hard to live in a time like this when you see the most beloved person to you, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who's more beloved to us than our parents and our children and everyone else. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam being insulted is not something light or easy in the heart of any believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam a role model for each and every one of us. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came to this universe and to this world with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take us out of darkness, to educate us, and for him to be a means for us to enter Jannah. It is sad to see a man who spent his life, alayhi salatu wasalam, to take the people out of darknesses and to take them to light. He spent his life, alayhi salatu wasalam, wishing that everybody would accept his message. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told us how it hurt him when he saw the people not taking his message. Allah says about him, لَعَلَّكَ بَاخِعُ النَّفْسَكَ أَلَّا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنِينَ. You would give your life out and cause yourself distress and hardship just so the people can take Islam and believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ignorant people, criminals, chose to insult the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, بِمَنِّهِ وَكَرَمِهِ وَقُوَّتِهِ and his strength, and يُرِيَنَا فِيهِمْ عَجَائِبَ قُدْرَتِهِ, that Allah shows us his power and his strength regarding them. My advice inshallah ta'ala here is for each and every one of you Muslim out there, how can you defend the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? There are two points I want to talk about. The first point I want to talk about inshallah ta'ala is that it's obligatory on each and every one of us to defend the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. The Quran and the Sunnah have shown us that we have to stand up and defend our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The second thing that I inshallah ta'ala want to talk about is, how do we defend the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam? How do we do it? So let me start with the first point inshallah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, الذين يتبعون الرسول النبي الأمي الذي يجدونه مكتوبا عندهم في التوراة والإنجيل يأمرهم بالمعروف وينهاهم عن المنكر ويحل لهم الطيبات ويحرم عليهم الخبائث ويضع عنهم إصرهم والأغلال التي كانت عليهم فالذين آمنوا وعزروه ونصروه واتبعوا النور الذي أنزل معه أولئك هم المفلحون. الله تبارك وتعالى, he said in this verse, the ones who follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Nabiullah Muhammad, they follow him in their hearts and they also physically follow him. They want to dress like him. They want to talk like him. They want to act like him. They want to take everything from him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In that ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told us that Nabiullah Muhammad, ya'muruhum bil ma'rufi, he commands them the good, wa yanhaahum 'anil munkari, and he prohibits from them the evil. وَيُحِلُّ لَهُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ, he made permissible for them that which is good. وَيُحَرِّمُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْخَبَائِثِ, and he prohibited from them that which is filthy and evil. وَيَضَعُ عَنْهُمْ إِسْرَهُمْ وَالْأَغْلَالَ الَّتِي كَانَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ, and he removed from them the shackles and the chains that were on them. Allah then says, فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those who chose to believe in him عليه الصلاة والسلام, ونصروه, and they gave victory to him صلى الله عليه وسلم, واتبعوا النور الذي أنزل معه, and they followed the light in which he came with, أولئك هم المفلحون, they are the successful ones. Brothers and sisters, فالذين آمنوا, the ones who believed in نبي الله محمد, وعزروه, honored him, ونصروه,
and gave him victory. وَاتَّبَعُوا النُّورَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ مَعَهُ and followed the light that was given to him صلى الله عليه وسلم. أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ they are the successful ones. الْفَلَاح success في الدنيا والآخرة in this world they are successful and they are also successful in the hereafter. الله سبحانه وتعالى he said لَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلَنَا بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْمِيزَانَ لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدَ فِيهِ بَأْسٌ شَدِيدٌ وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ وَلِيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَنْصُرُهُ وَرُسُلَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَوِيٌّ عَزِيزٌ الله تبارك وتعالى he told us and informed us that he has sent down the messengers with clear cut evidences وَأَنزَلْنَا مَعَهُمُ الْكِتَابَ Allah he says we sent down with them the book والميزان and the scale لِيَقُومَ النَّاسُ بِالْقِسْطِ so the people can be standing up in justice. وَأَنزَلْنَا الْحَدِيدَ Allah he says, we sent the metal, يعني the sword, فِيهِ بَأْسٌ شَدِيدٌ وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ in it is benefit for the people and harm. وَلْيَعْلَمَ اللَّهُ and so the people can know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala مَنْ يَنصُرُ رُسُلَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ Allah is the one who's going to give victory to his religion. And Allah is going to give victory to his messengers. وَرُسُلَهُ بِالْغَيْبِ Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما he said ينصرونهم لا يكذبونهم ويؤمنون بهم بالغيب Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to give victory to the messengers بالغيب يعني وهم لا يرونهم they don't see the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم these people are going to give victory to the Prophet by what are they going to do ينصرونهم لا يكذبونهم they won't disbelieve in the Prophet and the messengers وَيُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِمْ And they believe in these messengers. بِالْغَيْبِ أي وَهُمْ لَا يَرَوْنَهُمْ Even that though they haven't seen these prophets. We haven't seen Nabi Allah Muhammad. We haven't seen Isa ibn Maryam. We haven't seen Musa, Yaqub, Yusuf, Yunus, Hud, Salih, Nuh. We haven't seen all these prophets. But we believe them with unwavering conviction. That's how we're going to give victory to these prophets. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala mentioned. قال تعالى الله also says وإذ أخذ الله ميثاق النبيين لما آتيتكم من كتاب وحكمة ثم جاءكم رسول مصدق لما معكم لتؤمنن به ولتنصرنه قال أأقررتم وأخذتم على ذلكم إصري قالوا أقررنا قال فاشهدوا وأنا معكم من الشاهدين الله سبحانه وتعالى he said وإذ أخذ الله ميثاق النبيين when Allah took the covenant with the prophets لَمَا آتَيْتُكُمْ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَحِكْمَةٍ ثُمَّ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مُصَدِّقٌ لِمَا مَعَكُمْ لَتُؤْمِنُنَّ بِهِ وَلَتَنْصُرُنَّهِ Allah, he took a covenant. And he took a covenant with the righteous people. And he took a covenant with the prophets and the messengers. That when they come, these prophets, when they come with the message that they come with, and when they come with the wisdom, that we will give victory to them, and that we will believe in them. That which is required from us. Is that we give victory to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that we give victory to all the prophets of Allah by believing in them. فَمَنْ تَوَلَّى بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ And anyone who turns away from giving victory to the prophets, then that person is definitely in a state of loss. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, وَإِنِ اسْتَنْصَرُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ فَعَلَيْكُمُ النَّصْرُ If your Muslim brothers ask you for aid and support, and they ask you for victory and help and aid, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he said, فَعَلَيْكُمُ النَّصْرُ Give your brothers victory. What about the messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam? If he requires from us victory, أوجب, he is more important to us than any Muslim there is. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, he told us that we give victory to him. The noble companion, Abu Ruqayya Tamim ibn Awsin al-Dari, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, He mentioned, as Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih, that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said, "الدين النصيحة." The religion is based upon sincere advice. قلنا لمن the Sahabas they said to who O Messenger of Allah, لله ولكتابه ولرسوله ولأئمة المسلمين وعامتهم. It's victory to who? To Allah, to the Book, to the Messenger, and to the Muslims. And the Muslim leader. Al-Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah, when he commented on this hadith, he mentioned that the nasiha for the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is by what? فتصديقه على الرسالة It is to believe in his message that he came with صلى الله عليه وسلم والإيمان and it is also to believe بجميع ما جاء به everything which he came with and it also is وطاعته في أمره ونهيه to obey him in the things that he commanded us to do and it is also to stay away from that which he told us to stay away from ونصرته to give victory to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم حيا وميتا whilst he was alive the sahabas were giving victory to him they were defending him they were protecting him and now that he's passed away عليه الصلاة والسلام we give victory to him in following his sunnah obeying him staying away from that which he told us to stay away from ومعاداته and also showing animosity and hate to the people that show animosity and hate towards him صلى الله عليه وسلم وإحيائي and to revive his methodology to revive his path and his tradition صلى الله عليه وسلم وبث دعوتي and also to convey his message صلى الله عليه وسلم ونشر شريعته and also to spread his legislations on the earth and also ونفي التهمة عنها and also to remove any speculations that anyone tries to put regarding him صلى الله عليه وسلم My beloved brothers and sisters there are steps that we need to take in order to defend the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number one, we need to follow his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We need to do what he told us to do, and we should stay away from what he told us to stay away from. That is why Allah said in the ayah, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ Whatever he gave us, we should take it from him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And whatever he told us to stay away from, we should stay away from it. Number two, we obey him in everything he told us, and we follow his guidance. صلى الله عليه وسلم الله said in the Quran قل أطيع الله وأطيع الرسول obey Allah and obey the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم فإن تولوا if you turn away فإنما عليه ما حمل وعليكم ما حملتم وإن تطيعوه تهتدوا وما على الرسول إلا البلاغ المبين if we obey the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم guidance is in it for us the third thing is that we love his family the family of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم is beloved to us أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله تعالى عنه He narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم He said وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ I swear by the Lord In which my soul is in his hand لَا يَبْغَضُنَا أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا أَدْخَلَهُ اللَّهُ النَّارِ There is nobody who shows animosity and hate towards the family of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم except that Allah will enter them into the hellfire Also the fourth thing is to love his companions Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما he said that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said من سب أصحابي فعليه لعنة الله والملائكة والناس أجمعين anyone who insults my companions may the curse of Allah and the angels and all of the people be upon them the fifth is we show hate to every single person who says anything bad about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم we distance ourselves from that person we leave off their companionship قال تعالى الله said in the Quran وقد نزل عليكم في الكتاب أن إذا سمعتم آيات الله يكفر بها ويستهزأ بها فلا تقعدوا معهم حتى يخوضوا في حديث غيره إنكم إذا مثلهم إن الله جامع المنافقين والكافرين في جهنم جميعا Anyone who sits in a place where Allah's religion is being mocked and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is being mocked Allah first of all said to us فَلَا تَقْعُدُوا مَعْهُمْ Don't sit with those people حَتَّى يَقُوضُوا فِي حَدِيثٍ غَيْرِهِ Until they repent from what they said And if you still carry on staying with those people إِنَّكُمْ إِذَا مِثْلُهُمْ Then you are verily like them إِنَّ اللَّهَ جَامِعُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ Allah is going to gather the hypocrites and the disbelievers وَالْكَافِرِينَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ جَمِيعًا Allah referred to the people who sit in that gathering where the messenger has been mocked and the religion of Islam has been mocked and chooses to sit there and listen that he's a hypocrite and he and those disbelievers he sat with are going to be gathered together in the hellfire. The sixth one, brothers and sisters, is to nurture our children and our students and our youths upon the love of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَالدِّفَاعِ عَنْهُ And we nurture that, we place that spark of love and defending the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَالْغِيرَةِ عَلَيْهِ And that we show protective jealousy over the honor of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he is sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who's set for us a path to Jannah. Our salvation, our prosperity
is nowhere else can we get it except through him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If anybody says anything filthy about the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you can't in any way, shape or form do anything, hate this in your heart. That's all we can afford to do now. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger said, مَنْ رَأَى مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرْهُ بِيَدِي فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِلِسَانِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يَسْتَطِعْ فَبِقَلْبِهِ وَذَلِكَ أَضْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ. Any one of you who sees evil being done, change it with your hand. If you're not able to do it with your tongue. And if you're not able to do it, hate it in your heart, and that is the lowest of iman. Also, my beloved brothers and sisters, the way to defend the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is بيان خلقه وخلقه. It is this time and this moment that we bring out to the people the manners and the etiquettes that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had, and the way that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked, and how he dealt with people alayhi salatu wasalam. So we should specify lessons and muhadarat and lectures where we define and we speak about this noble man, Nabiullah Muhammad. Also, my beloved brothers and sisters, if boycotting the wealth of the French and anyone who insults the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to bring a change, لا شك ولا ريب, it's a path to take. المقاطعة المطلقة, if boycotting them has a, it's going to reach the goal, without a doubt, it becomes from the things that we can change the evil. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bimannihi wa karami. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he bestows his mercy upon us, and that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala does not show our eyes anyone who chooses to harm the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who insults him. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the people who chose to open their mouths on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to insult him, to put him down, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, that he sends on them that which he sent on Ashabul Fil. And yursil alayhim tayran ababil tarmihim bihijaratin min sijil faj'alahum ka'asfin ma'kool. That Allah destroys them, and that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala shows us his strength and his ability. Allahumma innaka qulta wa qawluka alhaq ud'uni astajib lakum. اللهم هذا دعاؤنا ومنك الإجابة وعليك التكلان ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بك. Oh Allah, we don't want to live a time and an era where we're seeing the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being defied and being disrespected and insulted. إنه يا رب العالمين. Oh Allah, show us intiqam, a retaliation for the rights of your Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'm going to conclude there, inshallah ta'ala. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.